Since version 1, TaskForce has been updated many times and features has been added. This is a recap overview that, starting with version 1, goes through all the updates in order up to the latest version 1.8. Let's copy this text block and paste it into the comp. Sometimes it may happen to work with very long text files like this one. To split the text into multiple rows, I added the separate tool here. It lets text separation by the common punctuation such as commas, periods, and so on. Let's try. Text is split into multiple rows and it is separated by comma and comma, etc. Well, let's undo and enable the remove punctuation option. Separate, and the punctuation is removed from the text rows. Of course, now it's very simple to edit each out-of-screen text block to make sure it's all readable. And when it's done, I click on the reset button, which, remember, if text is not animated, will save the text changes inside TaskForce expressions. Well, I remove all the text, and I'm gonna copy-paste a new text block. As you see, it is separated by new lines. So, in version 1.5, I added the ability to split text by new lines. Well, here there is a comma, but whatever. Let's try it. And done. Well, I added three brand new animation styles. They are on bottom. Zoom track, continuous slide, and rotational, also in the override panel. I already set the animation to let you see them in action. All right, they all work in rows and words mode, not paragraph. Another new feature is the text background. Just enable it and change the background color. The color box margin is set to 10 pixels. Animate. And it works. Let's increase the margin to 30 pixels. And as you see, the solid color is now bigger. Exactly 30 pixels. I can also enable the random color generator. Animate. In this case, each text block has a different background color. Look at these text blocks. Two rows, three rows, two rows again. As expected, the text blocks are separated by rows and words, but I can't really tell which cuts belong to the first block, the second, or the third. To get the visual feedback of each text block, there is a new labels option in the settings. So, set the first label to yellow and the second to blue. Let's animate again. As you see, each text block gets an alternative yellow or blue color. It will come in handy for the upcoming new animation and editing workflow. I set an audio sync animation. Have a look. Now open the Adjust Cuts panel here. It consists of three different tools. The first one is the Move tool, which can move the selection in order to start at current time or to end at current time. Okay, select just the first layer and move it back. As expected, all the following text stay in place. Undo, and now enable Move following text accordingly. As you see, all the following layers move back together with the selection. Of course, the opposite doesn't work because there are no layers following the last one. Okay, undo, and talk about the stretch. When the panel is open, a stretch layer is added on top. A quick look at the animations. Well, this animation is very slow, so let's stretch to make it faster. Layer selected, I set a stretch in at the starting marker. As you see, the stretch layer in point is set.
Now set the stretch out time. And when I click on set, the text animation is stretched to fit the stretch layer. Okay, now it works. You are allowed to stretch multiple layers at once. I'll show you later. Now, move on and talk about the out tool. So, let's pretend I need to make this layer hold on until the current time. Just click on the hold button. And as you see, the animation ends here, but not the layer endpoint. Undo. The other out option is to fade out. In this case, the animation stops here, and an opacity out make the layer disappear at current time. Well, before to move on, I want to show you the multi-stretch. Manually set the stretch layer in and out. You can. And select all the text animations, set, and as expected, all the layers are stretched accordingly. I loaded and generated sync markers already. In TextForce 1, when an animation is generated, it always starts at the first audio marker, right? Well, not anymore. In fact, in version 1.5, when I animate, the animation starts at the marker closer to current time, this one. This new approach makes it possible to animate and sync text blocks one by one. Undo, and open the Adjust Cuts panel. Select the first layer. Animate. The problem is, when I animate, the selected text overlaps the following text blocks. Well, not if I enable the Move Following Text option, because it also affects the Animate command. As you see, the following text blocks, animated or not, are adapted to the animated selection. Undo. Just to be clear, if the following option is enabled, but the panel is not open, the following option does not work. Undo, and open the Adjust panel again. So, you can really animate text one by one, and then adjust it the way you like, and recognize each text block thanks to the labels. Let's try it. Animate the first block. I like it. Select the next text block, set the time to the next good audio marker, and animate. This one is not cool, so I'll give it another try. Good, but this one is too short, so set the stretch in, the out, and set. Now it works. Well, move on the third block, animate. Cool. And now the last block. Oh, right. It is very slow because I set it to words. Let's open the override panel and force the rows split. Animate again. To make it end on the last music hit, I can fade out this text. Cool. Play all. Well, I hope you like new TextForce workflow and tools. They really give you the control and flexibility missed in version 1. This is a last minute add-on. In the styles window, when you disable the random directions, they are all still random. This option lets you choose to set some styles direction while keeping the others random. TextForce is now able to sync Premiere Pro generated captions to voiceovers. So, let's listen at this demo voiceover.
Hi, this is a demo to test the new much requested feature found in TextForce 1.6, the voiceover sync. Export subtitles from Premiere. TextForce will do the rest.
Go to Window menu and open the text panel. Simply transcribe the audio. Premiere analyzed the sequence audio tracks and it generated the matching text. After that, click on Create Captions. Make sure to select single line. It is very important on TextForce side. Here they are, the captions by lines. Let's move to the export menu and select export to CVS file. I'm gonna name it demo.cvs. Well, let's switch to After Effects. I already imported the same voiceover audio. I select the audio layer in the comp. In TextForce, I switch to audio sync and I load the audio track. The peaks markers are generated, but as you know, they don't work well on human voice. So let's try the new import option here. As you see, this option is disabled and I'm able to choose only rows and words split because import mode handles audio sync in a very different way. We open the CVS file exported from Premiere. I can choose to remove punctuation and I will. Generate. The new markers and text are generated. Let's see the new cuts.
Hi, this is a demo to test the new much requested feature found in TextForce 1.6, the voiceover sync. Export subtitles from Premiere. TextForce will do the rest.
And they are perfectly synced. The text transcribed by Premiere AI is almost perfect. I fix just a couple of words, .6 and the final E. Okay, select the text layers and animate.
Hi, this is a demo to test the new much requested feature found in TextForce 1.6, the voiceover sync. Export subtitles from Premiere. TextForce will do the rest.
Well, as you see, the text animations are very much in sync with the related voiceover words. A style I like for voiceovers is blink with by words option enabled. Set split to rows only and animate.
Hi, this is a demo to test the new much requested feature found in TextForce 1.6, the voiceover sync. Export subtitles from Premiere. TextForce will do the rest.
Well, it looks like there is a bit of sync delay. That's because the animations start with a short fade-in. To balance it, select everything, go forward just a few frames, then open the Edit Markers panel and delay the markers back 3 frames. Animate again and have a look.
Hi, this is a demo to test the new much requested feature found in TextForce 1.6. The voiceover sync. Export subtitles from Premiere. TextForce will do the rest.
Now sync is rock solid. Well, just to play, let's try word split with bold styles. Animate.
Hi, this is a demo to test the new much requested feature found in TextForce 1.6, the voiceover sync. Export subtitles from Premiere. TextForce will do the rest.
As you see, you can also animate splitting by single words and read all of them. I want to point out that if I get back to speed, of course the audio mode is disabled. But when I switch to audio again and allow the audio track, if the import mode is enabled, it will work and sync because all the sync data I loaded before are stored in the audio track. I'm gonna animate with rows and words splitting.
Hi, this is a demo to test the new much requested feature found in TextForce 1.6, the voiceover sync. Export subtitles from Premiere. TextForce will do the rest.
The animation are still synced.
So, version 1.7 add a new option to the time panel, current duration. It means that TextForce animates the text and keeps the original layer's durations.
animate. As you see, they are animated, but the layer's length doesn't change. Let's try again. It doesn't matter if text is broken into rows. The row's length matches the current length of each belonging paragraph. Okay, let's reset. If I want to modify the text duration, I just need to click on the reset button to apply. Animate. TextForce 1.8 add new features. The first one is a reworked styles window. Let's talk about the speed factors. They were introduced in version 1.5 and I moved them here to make the workflow easier. The speed factor is a simple way to set a speed value for each single animation style. I already set up a couple of overrides on these layers, just to make sure they are animated always the same way. Well, if I want to slow down animations, I can set a new speed value here. The problem is that all the layers' animation speed are affected. Undo and get back to 100%. If, instead, I want to tweak just the blink text animation speed, now I can increase the related speed factor value. Higher the value, slower the animation. Let's set 1.5. So, the zoom track animation lasts the same as before, just the blink one is slower. Another add-on is the reset buttons. They allow to reset each style options to default. Let's make some changes to blink. Reset. Done. Now, let's make some changes to multiple styles. To reset all styles at once, I can click on Reset All. Easy. I'm now able to turn styles and overrides off just by clicking on this checkbox. Of course, split, time and background settings will still affect the animations. Animate. As you see, this is just a way to cut text layers. I'm gonna set an animation, split by rows, slide left to right, and zoom far to close, speed at 90%, horizontal center only, and let's add a red background. Margin 20, animate, and that's what I get. If I want to save this setup, now I can, thanks to the preset feature. Just click on save and name it preset. If I click on the default button, TextForce gets back to default settings. Of course, when I animate, it will use all styles and split modes. To load the saved preset, I just need to click on the load button and load the saved preset. As you see, all the changes I made before are back. Animate again, and I get the same animation as expected. Well, that's all guys. Enjoy and also check on TextForce's new brother, LayerForce. Cheers!